there. I'm here with Suicidal Tendencies. Can you please introduce yourself?
My name is Mike Muir. I'm from Suicidal Tendencies.
Yeah, you're like the only permanent original member, right? That's what I've heard.
Yep, I was the only original member before we even did the record, so went through, depending on who you ask, there's 30 some odd people say they were in the band before we recorded the record, so.
Oh really? Yeah. Like before you recorded the first record?
Yeah.
But that's already a long time
ago.
That's
time. As time goes, people have memories that are different than reality, but.
Oh, okay.
You'll see that as you get older. People will tell you about remember when and you'll go, no. But that's
all right. Are you excited to play here tonight?
Yes, always. Last time we were in Holland, we played, and I'll probably say it wrong, Werpop, Werpop. It was this little, well, I'd say little, but it was a festival. It's like a community thing, and it's just for this one area. And there was 40,000 people there, just families and everything.
Wow.
Yeah, and it was crazy. It was so much fun. And it was weird because we had kids that brought their parents, kids that liked the band that brought the parents, and parents that liked the band that brought their kids.
Mm-hmm.
And it was,
that's
we're
cool.
Like, who brought who, you know?
You probably have like a very like big variety of like fans, because I mean, your band has been out there for a long time, and the music that you play appeals to younger people as well, so.
And so you get the younger and older people doing the festivals in Europe obviously helps out, because a lot of people, they'll see the name, they'll see it on shirts or hats and this and that, so they know. So when they're there, they said, okay, we'll check it out and stuff. So that helps us out.
Nice.
And then, you know, being, I guess, associated with a lot of different things, with skateboarding and that. My brother was a pro skateboarder, so we got all the skaters. You know, some people say punk, some metal, some thrash, some this and that.
Yeah.
And so we're able to do a lot of different things where, same thing in Holland, we played the year before, and I'll mess it up. Zwartkruise?
Zwartkruise!
Yeah,
oh,
we did that,
one.
Yeah.
But like doing this persistence tour, it's like a great way to start off 2014, I imagine.
No, definitely. We did it 2 years ago and it was a great experience. And the only thing we worry about, showing how wimpy we are from California, is the weather.
Oh, yeah.
And fortunately, it wasn't that bad at the beginning. And then the last two shows in Germany, there was a lot of snow and cold.
Yeah.
And I determined cold this way. When the people live there say, yeah, it's very cold here.
I'm like, yeah. It's cold.
I go, cold or real cold? Real cold. I say, okay, good. So I think there's a point where you have to feel comfortable where you were. We was in another band called Infectious Grooves.
Mm-hmm.
And we did a tour with Ozzy Osbourne years ago. And 20 shows, there was a bunch of them where they had all the police there, where someone's gonna take them to their underground city of gold, and they're worried about people assassinating them, all this.
Really?
And Ozzy's like, I'm scared of my fucking fans. And I'm like, I go, I would hate to be able to, you know, I'm just walking in the rain. I would hate to be in a situation where I don't feel comfortable.
Yeah, we have to be scared of the fans.
Yeah, it kind of thing and stuff. And you get, you know, just crazy people that just have no sense of reality or something. And that's the exception, but, you know, it carries over in life. You know, you should feel comfortable.
Yeah.
Not comfortable in the sense of lazy, but comfortable like you're in control.
Yeah. Have you ever had to deal with crazy fans like that?
You always have some occasional people that are little strange that don't quite get it. And I think a lot of times it's just alcohol or drugs or something, and they don't know that they're expressing their exuberance in a non-good way or something, you know?
Yeah.
And like last night, someone got on the stage and, you know, I like people. It's all right, we high five this and that. I don't want some fucking dude just squeezing in here. Dude, I'm trying to sing a song and like,
oh,
give me this huge, you know, my kids don't even squeeze. All right, like, dude, get off, you know?
What, like a sweaty guy?
You get them off and stuff, and beard rubbing up the face. I don't want that. I mean, I'm sorry. And you get them off, and then he does it again and yanks, you know, and stuff. So it's like, dude, this isn't cool. So you have to throw him down. And then the funny thing was, he got slammed down pretty hard. He looked, and I think he had that sober moment when I was on top of him, slammed him. I was like, I can't hit people because that would be not a thing to do. But they came and rushed him off, and he had this look like, oh shit, I think I did that wrong. And he was at the side of the stage later, and there's someone up there, and I went like that, and he's like, So we all learn lessons in life different ways.
Yeah, I can imagine. I mean, it's at least it's memorable, you know? It's like,
yeah, yeah.
You'll remember that show.
Yeah, well, he will. He's he probably will hurting right now. But there was a time that we were with the management, I won't say who, but management was one of the biggest in the world. And they said, you guys are doing great, you know? We did a big tour, big festival tour, and they said, you're getting all these new people in the band. And I go, but I walk out after the show, and it's like, I don't want to talk to these people. It's like, dude, you're that dude, you rock, dude, take a beer, I don't drink, dude, you do, yeah, dude. And that's like for 15 minutes, and you're just like going, oh my, you know, I gotta get out of here, you know, going crazy.
What do you think are some of the highlights in your career so far?
Well, I think it's interesting because a lot of times people talk about the good old days and life in general, and usually they're people that do a lot of drugs and they don't remember how miserable they were back then because they're miserable now and they think it was better then. But we've been very fortunate because we just like, in this last year, we went to headline a festival in Indonesia, never been there before. And we're headlining a festival in South Korea in August.
Cool.
Going to Thailand and a lot of places we've never played before.
That's cool.
And at this day and age, when we go there, it's different than if you would have went years ago and you're kind of like roughing it, so to speak, and you actually meet a lot of people. You get to meet people in a sense of what the culture's actually about and stuff, and hang out, and there's people that know you and people that know someone else that is like, you know, one of good friends, like we say vouch for, one of, you know, your good friend says, hey, I know this guy was surfing in Indonesia, there's this whole little community there,
That's cool.
It's gonna, you know, is it cool, you should hook up with them and stuff, they have this shop, go by there and this and that. And you go there, next thing you know, you're at this thing having a barbecue and stuff, and all, meeting all these people, and everybody's like this and that, and then you leave, and people got tears in their eyes, and you're like, dude, don't make me cry, and stuff, and so, and they're writing back, oh, and give you all these gifts, and you're like, crazy and really cool people, and then they're, you know, they come to America, they're like, oh, or, you know, are you going to be in Australia, are you going to be here or there, and it's really, really good situation and opportunity, and, so I think that's probably the best situation and stuff, you know.
Yeah,
so
it seems so amazing to be able to have like friends and communities all over the world.
And the big difference, I think, you know, when we were playing like with other big bands, I mean, we played here in 93 with Metallica and Guns N' Roses, we were switching, and so you're able to go to all these places, but it was just because who you were with and that type of thing, and it was so fake, a lot of the stuff. And this is more like actual, you know, it seems more, it's like, it's hard, I mean, that sounds very judgmental, but you go to situations where you go, this doesn't mean anything to me and stuff, and everybody's trying to put on a certain facade and act like they're important, the way they, you know, it's like they practice even how they're holding their drink in the mirror, like, you know, and stuff. And, but here it's more like a situation where people, like, a lot of people just been through a lot, they like what they're doing, and it's a cool situation, and it's fun.
Exactly. I mean, like, talking about like these big bands that do all this stuff, like, have you ever like thought like consciously about like your reputation and how to behave and everything in that sense?
The only way I think about it in terms is, one is my family, how I was brought up, and then my kids and stuff, you know. So I'm fortunate because, you know, I bypassed the whole drug thing. I never did that. I saw the people that were older than me and it didn't work for them, and I don't drink and stuff, so I remember things, and my dad always says regret lasts forever, think before you do it, and everything that I didn't want to do or kind of felt bad about afterwards, I felt worse. So I sit there and, you know, I'm very comfortable saying no. And that's one thing I learned from my dad.
Yeah.
But just in general, he said the toughest thing in life is learning how to say no. People can say no, but they don't mean it.
Yeah.
And my dad always said, you know, I'm not going to yell and I'm not going to scream. I said no. If you can't hear it, I'll say it a little bit louder.
Yeah.
But no means no.
Yeah.
If you need to talk about it, we'll talk about it. If it makes you feel better, I'm not going to change what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I know why I'm saying it. And where some people, you know, this and that. And, and I think it's conviction, you know, and that's the whole thing. When you say it, don't say something unless you mean it. If you don't mean it, don't say it. You don't have to scream at the top of your lungs or this or that.
Yeah.
But it's like, no, it's like, nah, it can happen. And, you know, so many times being in a band, people are like, hey, dude, if you were cool, you'd do this. And I have to say, I guess I'm not cool. I'm not gonna do it. You know? And they don't know it. Dude, you're not fucking cool. I'm not? oh no, yes. You know, and exactly. They don't know what I am. Yeah. People are so worried about people, what people think that they don't even care exactly. about, don't know about, that aren't important or anything, that exactly. it messes things up. And yeah. so I think that's in life with suicidal. It's like, it's not about not worrying about other people, but worry about the things you need to worry about, and yeah. the little things, don't worry about it. There's yeah. gonna be a lot of big things you don't want to happen, so yeah. be prepared for those.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much for this interview. Cool. I'm really looking forward to seeing you play.
Cool. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks.